ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை 11th பாசுரம். கற்றுக்கரவை கடங்கள் பல கரந்து செற்றார் திரளழிய சென்று செரு செய்யும் குற்றமொன்றில்லாத கோவலர்த்தம் பொற்கொடியே புற்றரவல் குல் புனமையிலே போதராய் சுற்றத்து தோழிமார் எல்லாரும் வந்து நின் முற்றம் புகுந்து முகில் வண்ணன் பேர்பாட சிற்றாதே பேசாதே செல்வ பெண்டாட்டினி எற்றை குரங்கும் பொருளேலோரெம்பாவாய். The third scene of Thiruppavai commences from the 11th பாசுரம். We have been seeing that Aandaal is trying to wake up her friends and make them join for the Margari Vrata or Pavai Nombu. It seems that many of these friends are already here, but Aandaal does not want to leave out even a single friend of hers, and so she is making this attempt. In the second scene of Thiruppavai, Aandaal woke up five friends or five kinds of friends, and these friends were the ones who were relatively new to their group, the junior ones. Now in the third scene, Aandaal is going to wake up five other friends or five types of friends who are very, very senior in their group. In spite of being senior, these girls have not come. So when Aandaal is waking them up, she reminds them of their seniority and says that it is their responsibility to come and take lead and take them to the Lord. So the first girl in this senior group is somebody like Rukmini Devi, it seems, the consort of Krishna. And Aandaal has reached the house of this girl who is like Rukmini Devi, and she is calling out to her, singing the glory of her family, because the entire family is highly dutiful and devoted. So Aandaal is hailing the praise of this family as she starts the pasuram. Katrukkaravai kadangal palakarandu செற்றார் திரளழிய சென்று செரு செய்யும் குற்றமொன்றில்லாத கோவலர்த்தம் பொற்கொடியே. She calls out to this girl as பொற்கொடியே. பொற்கொடி refers to the golden creeper. This girl is as beautiful as a golden creeper, it seems. That's why she is like Rukmini Devi, they say. Because Rukmini Devi was Hiranyavarna or golden in color. She was the avatara of Lakshmi Devi, and so just like Lakshmi Devi, she was golden hued, and her very name suggests the fact that she was golden in color, in complexion, and also in glow. So also this girl is resembling Rukmini Devi. And why is she resembling Rukmini Devi? Because Rukmini Devi herself said to Krishna in the letter that she wrote that she was most suitable for him as a bride. She says, Katva mukunda mahati kula shila rupa vidyavayo dravinaha dhamabhi atmatulyam. She tells Krishna that I am equivalent to you in age, vaya, in dharma, in wealth, and also in character. So you are the right choice for me and I am the right choice for you. This is what she tries to convey to Krishna in her letter. So also this girl is an exact match for Krishna, it looks like. So this girl is a senior and she is very, very important, and so Aandaal has come to her house, this Porkodi's house. Now this Porkodi's family is being described, as I said in the beginning. So all the words before the word Porkodiye is talking about the family of this Porkodi. The family of this Porkodi is a Gopika family or Gopa family, because all these girls are in Bhavana Prakarsham now. According to them, Srivilliputur is Gokulam and everybody there are Gopas and Gopikas. So this family of Gopas, Porkodi's family, is a very dutiful one. What is their duty? the duty is to take milk from the cows and do milk business. It seems they are very adept at doing this. They are saying that they always milk cows at the right moment. kaTRuk kaRavai kaṇangal palakarandu. These people have learnt very well how to milk the cows. The art of milking cows is very well learnt by these people, it seems. kaTRuk kaRavai. kaRavai refers to the cows which yield milk. And kaTRuk kaRavai means learning how to milk these cows. And these gopas are very good at it. And they have innumerable number of cows, it seems. Kanangal palakarandu. They have lot of cows, innumerable number of cows, it seems. They are very, very rich and they have vast cattle groups. So, they are trying to milk all the cattle all by themselves. They have not employed people to do it. They are doing it all by themselves. And all the cows are being milked very perfectly without anything getting spilt, without anything being dirtied. And so, these people are doing their duty at their best. And why are they doing their duty at their best? Because they want to keep themselves fit, it seems. By milking cows, you develop good arms and good muscles. And they are trying to develop these muscles for a particular purpose. What is that purpose? Setrar thiralaiya sendru seru cheyum. It seems they have to go for seru, that is yuddha or war. And they have to go for a war whenever they are being required. And when is a war going to be coming in Gokulam? It will come every time a demon comes to attack Krishna. So they want to keep themselves ready to protect Krishna from any kind of danger. That is why they are ensuring that they are completely fit and available for Krishna to protect him from any possible danger. And so it seems that these people are very proactively trying to prevent danger. So if they sense that any danger is coming around, they would go and proactively fight with that danger, fight with the person causing danger or the demon causing danger. That's why Andal says, Sendru seru cheyum. They go and fight. They go for a war. It's not that they will combat if they are called for a war. They actually go and drive away the enemy proactively. They do it even before the enemy calls out to them. Such is their love for Krishna and so much they feel for his safety. That is why these people are keeping themselves absolutely fit. So, the house of this Porkodi has gopas, kovalar, who are milking cows regularly, keeping themselves fit and always ready to go and have war with Krishna's enemies. Such is the glory of your house, Andal says. Now, this is a very commendable thing that somebody is trying to protect Krishna and for that sake, he is maintaining himself in the perfect state. So, Andal wants to hail these people. So, she's talking about the family even before she talks about the girl. So, this Porkodi girl belongs to such a good family who is devoted to Krishna. Despite that, she's still sleeping. So, Andal is calling out to her again. This time, describing her beauty. Putraravalgul punamayile podarai. Oh, beautiful one. You must come with us now. How beautiful are you? Putraravalgul. Look at your waist. It is like a slim snake that is present inside its hole. They say that the snake which is present in the hole has more charm than the one which is present out or which is probably caught by a snake charmer. If a snake is caught, it loses all its charm. But if it is in its own hole, in its own place, then the charm of the snake is something magnificent. And such is your charm. Putraravalgul punamayile. You are also like the peacock who keeps walking so beautifully that it seems like a dance when you walk. Now, why is Andal talking about the snake and the peacock? This is because Andal is always thinking about Krishna. And this Gopika, this Porkodi is also thinking about Krishna always. Because Andal is thinking about Krishna, she's thinking about the Lord's serpent bed, the snake. And how the peacocks dance looking at the dark cloud colored lord, or how the lord wears a peacock feather in his crown. So she's thinking of all adjectives associated with the lord to describe this girl. So also this girl Porkodi has developed these characters because she's constantly contemplating about the lord. She's thinking so much about the lord that anything associated with him has become her characteristic. So she has developed a waist like the lord's serpent, and she has developed a graceful walk like the peacock associated with the lord. Such is her beauty, and this beauty has come only out of divine devotion. So Andal very lovingly calls out to her, Punamayile Podarai, please come. All of us have come now. Sutrathu Thozhimar ellarum vandu, and we have come even into your house. Nin mutram pugundu, we have come into your house, she says. Mutram is a small place, a lobby kind of a thing inside the house, a lobby with a open which is open to the sky. So these girls have reached this mutram of this Porkodi's house, and Andal is telling her that we are all here right inside your house. Nin mutram pugundu, and what are we doing? We are singing his glory. Mugilvannan perpada, we are singing the glory of that cloud like lord. Mugilvannan refers to the lord having a cloud like color, and you are Punamail, you are somebody like a peacock. So shouldn't you come out and dance to our song about the lord? Please come, they call. Instead of coming, you are just being inside. Sitrade pesade selva pendatini, you are not coming out, you are not even yielding to us, you are not talking to us. Sitrade pesade, but you are very important to us, we cannot leave you and go, because you are selva pendati, you are a treasure to our group and to Krishna. Selva pendati refers to the one who is very very precious to Krishna. Pendati can also mean wife, so you are like a precious wife to Krishna, because this girl is resembling Rukmini Devi. So they are using this terminology here. Selva pendatini yetrai urangum porul, please tell us the reason why you are sleeping despite having so many wonderful qualities. You must come and join us, these girls say. And so this girl Porkodi is impressed by their talk and immediately comes out and joins them.